Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now this video is a shootout between four cameras shooting in the 4K mode. I wanted to understand the differences between the quality produced by a 1/2-inch sensor, a 1-inch sensor, an APS-C sensor and the Micro Four Thirds. So I've got the Canon 740HS, the Canon EOS M50, the Panasonic Lumix FZ2000 and the Panasonic Lumix G9. So I want to look at the quality from each of those cameras. Now originally I started to shoot this outdoors, but unfortunately the changing light conditions meant it was very difficult to make some objective decisions about the image quality. So I've decided to reshoot it indoors using studio lights so I can gain a correct exposure and color temperature for each of the shots across all the four cameras. Now I also wanted to look at the image quality difference between shooting with the Canon EOS M50 using an adapted EF lens, and in this case it's going to be the 100-400L series lens, and I'm going to use that at its 400mm position. When you combine that with the crop factor of the camera when you're shooting 4K, it gives an effective focal length of about 1000 or 1100mm, so that would be ideal for wildlife. Now I have done some tests with that lens at 400mm and shooting video it looks incredibly sharp, but it's quite a combination to carry around, so I wanted to check that out against the Canon 740HS travel zoom, which again can accommodate 1000mm without any problem, but it's obviously from a 1/2-inch sensor. We'll get more depth of field, but what I'm concerned about is the tonal range or dynamic range that sensor would produce in a variety of lighting situations, so this test may help me understand that difference. Okay, let's have a look at my test that I'm going to run today. It's the same situation for the four cameras, controlled lighting, so there's no variation between each shot. You can make your own mind up as to the image quality, the amount of depth of field, the tonal range and the resolution from each of those cameras. Well, the first test is with the Panasonic Lumix FZ2000 or 2500. I'm going to try and keep the magnification the same for each of the videos so that the comparison is going to be similar. This one is ISO 160 at f6.3 and the shutter speed is 1/40th of a second. So now change over to the Canon EOS M50 and we'll put the Canon 100-400 lens on there and get the same magnification. So this is the Canon EOS M50 with the Canon 100-400mm lens. The lens is currently set to about 200mm to give the same coverage as the FZ1000. Exposure is exactly the same, 1/40th of a second, f6.3 at ISO 160. So this is the Panasonic Lumix G9. And it has the Olympus 40-150mm lens with its 1.4x teleconverter, so it's a Pro Series lens. The exposure on the G9, the ISO only goes down to 200, so I'm currently shooting with ISO 200, 1/40th of a second at f6.3, and we're shooting in the CineLite D profile. I have to move the camera forward about 3 meters from the previous setup, but now the dolls are about 6 meters away from the camera. So this is the Canon SX740HS, it's a travel zoom camera. We don't have the same control that we do have in the other cameras in terms of exposure, but I've managed to get the exposure similar. So we're about a 1/60th of a second, f5.6 and ISO 160. So this is the Panasonic Lumix FZ80. I've added this into the sequence as again a 1/2-inch sensor where I can control the exposure more than I can with that Canon 740HS. So we've got the same exposure here, 1/40th of a second, f6.3 and ISO 160. This is the Olympus OMD EM1 Mark II with the Olympus 40-150mm plus the teleconverter, shot in cinema 4K, 24 frames per second. Well, that's it for this short video. Hope you found that information useful. If you are a new viewer to the channel, please do click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon and you'll be notified when I upload new videos to my channel. Also check out my photographic blog and you'll find a link to that in the video description below. Now that photographic blog covers all sorts of cameras from travel zoom all the way up to full frame cameras, so there's lots of information for all photographers there. And on the homepage is the application form to join my 3-weekly newsletter group. Now that newsletter goes out to 2,300 people at the moment and it's a technical publication in its own right. It's some information I don't normally publish in the blog, but it's a way of saying thank you for following me on the channel and following the news group. So please do check that out if you've not already done so. So until my next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.